And before I get into the Harley, one of the quiche kind of items that I find interesting that all of a sudden seems to be hot is Napco pottery. What is Napco pottery? Let me share my screen here and show you. Let's see. Okay. Napco, N-A-P-C-O. This company was in the 50s and 60s in the pottery or ceramics business, and they made a host of things, different figurines. One of them that we first caught on to are little flower vases. These are small little items. They're only about 5 to 6 inches tall. And when you're going to an estate sale, for people who like to flip items, meaning you like to, you know, spend a couple hours on a Saturday at an estate sale, buy things cheap, and then put them onto eBay and sell them quickly for, you know, a nice profit. These items we found, this one, for example, we bought this at an estate sale. You see the picture here at the estate sale for $5. We cleared it up, cleaned it up a little bit. We photographed it nicely, which is a secret to making money at estate sales, or if you're going to be doing an auction, is nice photography. And we actually sold this on eBay. We put some flowers in it, and we actually sold this on eBay quickly, within a matter of a few hours, for $36. So those are the types of things. Now, Napco did, in addition to these vases, they did a whole sort. They did ornaments and this plate. If you were brought up in the 50s and 60s.
My grandmother had that.
Christian home. Yes. Exactly. Exactly. You probably had one of these hanging in your house. We bought one and sold it within at a consignment shop within hours for $18. Somebody came in and said, just what you did. My grandmother used to have one of those. I want to get one. So those are Napco items. We love when we go to an estate sale, we love things that are sold in lots. Lots typically, or oftentimes, a lot will mean that whoever's running the sale, they don't really know what to do with all these things, or they feel that they're just too many of them to price individually. And if you know what you're looking for, you can often find treasures in a lot. So here's a lot. This goes back to the flower vases. This was at another sale. We found this. We bought all of these for $65, and we sold them individually as individual pieces on eBay for a total of $225. Last week, of course, it's this time of the year, we found a lot of Christmas ornaments or Christmas figurines. And again, we're going to sell those individually. To be honest, Dennis, I forget. I think we've bought this lot for... I think around $50. I don't remember exactly how much, $50, $60. But we'll make, you know, five times that amount selling these individually. The Harley items that you mentioned. Let's see here. Yeah, we have and this is an interesting, if you're in the business, how did we find this guy? Well, I was this rare finds consignment shop is a project that I'm helping out a friend with, helping her to get it up and running. So there was a guy over a few weeks ago who was changing the door locks on the doors. And I just started talking to him, and he was asking about the store. And he mentioned that over the years, he's been a collector of Harley Davidson memorabilia and things. So there's this locksmith in the store who's got this, you know, just through discussion, he's got this. So he invited us over to see it. And we're going to be doing an auction he's got figurines, he's got posters, and let me show you this one in particular. This poster, he collected these items. There are a lot of items that were made exclusively for dealers. They were not available to the general public. This poster, I think there was 115 of them printed. When I started researching this last year, there were a number of sales of this poster over the last few years. Last year, this poster sold for $1,800 and change. We just, last week when we were doing research on it, the latest sale of this poster was $2,300 for a poster. So again, and that comes just through, you know, having a conversation with somebody and finding out that he had no thoughts about, you know, putting this stuff up for sale. He had just collected it over the years. A lot of Christmas ornaments. Now, these Christmas ornaments, show another one here.
Is that the Grinch?
No, it's not. It's like the glass.
I saw the green. I thought it was a Grinch on a Harley.
Sort of regular glass. I forget the prices. The boxes actually on the bottom have the original retail. These are all collectibles. You know, they went out of production some years back. These ran, I believe, around $6 to $8. Now I want to show you something. When we did our research, see if I can find this. Here's one. This was not our sale, but right. This one sold on eBay for $34. So an $8 item. And we've got dozens and dozens of these that he has in his collection that we're going to sell. So the Harley collection, we've got parts, we've got watches worth four or five, this Stein, again, this is, let me see if I can get the collect, this is one of, 125, is that? 195 of these were made.
117.
This was number 117 of 109. One just sold, excuse me, guys. One just sold recently for almost $900.
Yeah, so it's almost like, I like to say the collectibles are almost like stock. A lot of times people collect it, but they're afraid to let it go. And that's why knowing what's hot, what's not, and when to let stuff go, even if you're a collector, I mean, you can buy more stuff. So.
Right. Right.
The accountant in me always says, you got to monetize at some point.
I like that. Yeah, that's exactly right. And that's where this guy is right now. He says it's time. The beauty is he's been collecting them. So he's been saving them in the original boxes. They're like brand new. Barbie, did you know there were Harley Davidson Barbie dolls?
I did not.
I didn't know. And they're really cool. So that was the Harley Davidson.
Awesome. Excellent. Excellent. So again, I know we were going to formalize, I want to formalize it. So what, you know, kind of go through in your eyes right now, what's hot and what's not. So, you know, it's always good to talk about what's hot. That's easy, but it's easier to talk about what's not. So like sitting on things and think, I mean, it's better to talk about because there's a lot of people sitting on stuff that, oh, I've been told this is worth a lot. And they've been holding it and they've kind of held too long. It's like GE, you know, they held the stock way too long. So what is, so from your perspective, you know, what's not hot or what's not?
A couple things immediately come to mind. Hess trucks. I think a lot of us collected Hess trucks with the thought in mind that they were going to increase in value over the years. Hess trucks, you almost can't give them away. If you can get $10 for one that's in like new condition in a brand in a box, that's all you're going to get for it. Unfortunately, I've
did they have they had where they peaked, right? And those were the old metal ones. Like there was a time when they were hot, and then now they're not. It's like anything else; they run their cycles.
Yeah, absolutely, right, exactly. Hess trucks, and we run across them fairly recently. The woman that's opening up Rare Finds in the store, she probably has 30 Hess trucks sitting in that store, and they're in a pile back in the corner. Right. Furniture. Every time we get somebody who wants to run an estate sale, there's always furniture involved. Furniture is very iffy. Some things will sell. End tables tend to sell very quickly. But dining room tables, China hutches, nobody has them in their house anymore. You can't, we really can't even.
People don't collect China, right?
Right.
We have a, look at China.
We have a very difficult time even donating those, giving them away. So furniture is a very iffy sort of thing. Books and magazines, there's usually when somebody's running estate sale, there are books and magazines. Some are extremely valuable. It's just a matter of knowing, you know, what you have and what you're looking for. And again, we'll have experts on the show to talk about things like that. Magazines, what magazines are hot, what magazines are going up in value. And comic books is another big one. Certain comic books are extremely valuable. Others are not even worth what they sold for the day they were first put on, you know, right, came to the bookstore or the magazine shop. So I'm trying to think.
So, yeah. I mean, that's an expert in a skill. So, I mean, you must invest a lot of time, money, and effort in really pricing out the items and finding out what it is for someone as well, right?
Yeah, we have to. We do a lot of research going in. First of all, my company, Caring Transitions, we spend a great deal of effort and expense in professionally photographing items, particularly if we're going to be holding an auction, because in an auction, an online auction, people can't hold things in their hands. So, you know, it's got to be professionally photographed, which we do. And then research, you know, we don't research every single item, but when you have a Harley Davidson Barbie doll, what's it worth? You know, we've got to do a little bit of research, and find out that poster, who knew that Harley Davidson poster is going to be worth $2,000. I mean, we would have sold that for maybe $20 online.
Expert like you really pays for itself.
Right. We go through that expense for our clients, that expense and that service for our clients. We work on a commission when we do an estate sale and an auction. So we want to get as much money for the item, frankly, as you, the homeowner, the owner does. So we go through that expense to ensure that one day end up on Antiques Roadshow and somebody saying, well, we went to this estate sale that Caring Transitions ran and we bought this thing for $10, you know, and it's worth, you know, $150,000.
Yeah, that's not the press you want to get.
Yeah, no.